shall I think?
Aika siisti. I can take this with me.
No.
Bosch on yksi maailman suurimmista alihankkijoista autoteollisuudessa, ja sen takia Boschin teknologia löytyy lähes jokaisesta automerkistä. Ajattelepa vaikka sun lempiautomerkkiä. Hyvällä todennäköisyydellä siitäkin löytyy Boschin teknologia. Me ollaan täällä upeassa Boschin innovaatiokeskuksessa Budapestissa. Tässä jaksossa me tutustutaan Boschin ekspertteihin ja samalla me tutustutaan, mitä he tekevät täällä ja minkä takia he ylipäätänsä tekevät näitä asioita. Lähdetään ottamaan selvää. Bosch on paljon muuta kuin pelkästään koodinkoneet tai työkalut. Nimittäin Bosch voisi kutsua melkein high-tech powerhouseksi, joka ottaa jatkuvasti edistysaskeleita esimerkiksi AI:n kanssa sekä terveydenhuollossa että monessa muussa asiassa. Boschin teknologia löytyy kaikkialta. Puhelimista, kameroista, autoista, sähköpyöristä, julkisesta liikenteestä sekä muualta.
Welcome here.
Nice to meet you.
Tässä jaksossa tutustutaan Xongoriin, joka on autorakastaja sekä vanhempi asiantuntija sähköisen voimansiirron kehittämisessä. Hän johtaa isoa tiimiä, joka on erikoistunut sähköisen voimansiirron teknologiaan. Hänen työnsä keskittyy sähköautojen haasteiden selvittämiseen, erityisesti akkujen tehokkuuteen. Hänen tiiminsä fokusoi kehittääkseen näitä järjestelmiä säästäen samalla energiaa maksimoidakseen potentiaali.
So what we are designing here, basically we are calling it EXL. So that's driving the wheels, that's driving the electrical cars. So we have three main components. One power electronic unit, an electrical machine, and a transmission. At the end, if we are manufacturing such kind of a thing, we have to examine it. What we would like to do, basically, to examine the e-machine. So the radiated sound of the e-machine. Because first, if we are ready with this kind of component, we are examining lots of things like power, torque, and so on. But one important measure that what is the audible noise at the end. For that, we are doing component measurement. That's what you can see here. But we have an expert here, Mate. So please, Mate, help us out.
Hello. Nice to meet you, Rasmus.
Okay, so this is a near field intensity probe. Sounds fancy, but imagine this is a microphone just in 3Ds. So you don't just have the information, what is the sound, but also where is it going, or from where is it coming, and which direction is it headed. And you have this cool looking sphere on it because the stereo camera can track where we are exactly. So if you look at the monitor right now, and what you do is you scan the surface, and then you have a full map of how is sound radiated from this component, in which direction, does it radiate the sound?
What you are seeing here, then we are implementing into a car and measuring it in the car.
Yeah.
Siis aivan uskomattoman hienoja juttuja, mitä Songler tässä meille kertoi. Wow. Siis mä en ymmärrä puolikaan, mutta tää on tosi silmiä avaavaa nähdä tällaisia asioita ja kuulla tällaisia juttuja ammattilaiselta.
Please follow me to the large chamber.
Yes, let's go. So, oh my god, what is going on?
And this is a virtual street. And what you can notice here, that the floor is like on the streets.
Yeah, exactly.
But
yeah.
All the sidewalks are isolated. So it means that it's a ideal street without any noise, just the noise which is coming from that vehicle which we will test. We again have here Mate.
Nice.
Could you please help us out that what is this room and why we built up this huge environment here? What does it serve?
This is one of the largest vehicle anechoic chambers in Europe. So it's really, really a large one. And we need the size to be able to do some special acoustic measurements with loaded cars. So we can turn the car, we can really turn it on to high speeds, still stay very silent. And we can do a so-called pass-by measurement even with this size that the car virtually passes by. We have achieved that with microphones and some technology sweeping the characteristic, but this is why the size is needed so that we can even do this indoor measurements that would perhaps require an outside measurement normally.
What's up with the screen?
Yeah, it's an additional feature which we would like to show. So Mate brought here the acoustic camera.
Yeah, acoustic camera?
Exactly.
Wow, it looks like a Transformers.
Yeah, but it has a meaning.
The arms are full of microphones, actually. So if you go over here, you can see those little dots. And those are all measurement microphones, measuring sound precisely.
Oh.
And then you have an algorithm behind, just like radars, beamforming algorithm, and it matches where is the sound coming from.
So that guy creates that picture, which you have there. So,
hello, mom.
Yeah. Can you see that instant moment when you are speaking?
Ooh. Hello.
And right now what we are doing, we are checking the system. And the system is the car, basically. And in a car, we are implementing a drivetrain. And after that, we can measure it as a whole, that which part and which direction, which surface do we radiating sound or something like that? And would it be in between the limits which were predefined?
Wow, so, siis that's amazing. Like, miten toi on mahdollista, että se, mä puhun, niin toi kaappaa äänestä samaa. Kattokaa. Wow.
Mä kuulin, että Songor on aika kova autoasiantuntija, jota lähdetään testaamaan, kuinka hyvin hän tunnistaa autojen, moottoreiden äänet. Lähdetään katsoa.
Okay, so I have a test for you. I heard you are a really, really big car enthusiast. So I have a three engine sounds okay. for you. And you have to guess if it's V12, V10 or V8. So are okay. you ready for the challenge?
Yeah, maybe. So don't forget that I'm an electrical drivetrain developer. It's like something like a V8 or old American or something like that.
You are correct.
V10?
That's V12.
Oh. It's V12.
It is V12.
It's an Italian, I'm pretty sure.
You are correct. Hey, congratulations. You
Thank
won the
you
game.
Much. That Thank was, you very much,
that was, that was really nice.
It was funny.
Nice, wow.
Nyt me ollaan nähty, mitä Songor tekee työkseen. Ja seuraavaksi mennään katsoa tuonne seuraavaan huoneeseen, että mitä Anna tekee. Eli ilmeisesti siellä on joku pieni osa, mikä tekee moottorin. Oikeastaan moottorin tärkein asia. Joten lähdetään katsomaan, mitä sieltä löytyy. Let's go.
Hello!
Hi!
Hi! Nice to meet you,
nice
Rasmus.
To meet you.
Annalla on 8 vuoden kokemus simulaatioinsinöörinä ja 4 vuoden kokemus insinööripäällikkönä. Hän tuo laaja osaamista hänen roolinsa. Hän erikoistuu tehomoduulien kehitykseen, kriittiseen komponenttiin, joka liittää akuston sähköisen moottoriin inverterissä. Hänen työnsä ulottuu tuotteen koko käyttöikään, alkuperäisestä konseptista tuottamiseen sekä pidemmälle.
So, what's going on here?
Yes, so I'm responsible of designing power modules, which are basically the heart of the electric drivetrain. I like to call it the heart, because this is the component that creates from the DC current that is coming from the battery an alternating current for the motor. And this switching, like tack, 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 is like the heartbeat.
Oh.
So that's why we like to call that this part here is actually the heart of the electric drivetrain. So these are like the plus minus connectors towards the battery, and these are the three connectors for the three-phase motor. We have chips inside, so this switching is realized by chips, so semiconductors. So in this product we have so high power density that we have to cool it with water. So we have water cooling here, so this fin that you see here is directly connected to the water chain of the car. And then it is directly water cooled.
Siis tää näyttää, can I touch it?
Of course.
Oh, it's kind of heavy. Wow. Kattokaa miten siisten näköinen. Siis tää on käytännössä niinku moottorin sydän. Aika siisti. How expensive this part can be?
In the end, in your car, I don't know how much it takes, but it's several thousand euros
several thousand
as a sample.
Euros. Wow.
Yeah, so basically the most expensive part of this product is the chip itself.
Yeah.
So maybe we can take a look how it looks like if I put it back. So basically inside this we have the chips. So this what you have here is like a newer generation of that module.
Okay.
So instead of this black material, we have here a gel, which is a translucent material, so you can see actually inside.
Wow.
And those like little rectangles are the chips that make the this whole things work. Yeah, it has a lot of copper in it.
Yeah.
And yeah, that's the shiny thing.
I can see it. I can take this with me.
No.
Well, but it's really really nice.
So we can use an infrared camera to measure the temperature. Because when I turn it on, this will get like super hot, and then you will see how the temperature goes up. Yeah, now it measures
actually,
your hand.
It, yeah. Joo, it's instantly. Saman tien, kun mä laitan käden tuohon, niin se laittaa tuohon lämpötilaan, että paljon mun kädessä on lämpö. Siis wow, saman tien, kun mä laitan käden tuohon, niin toi lämpötila muuttuu sen mukaan. Siis ihan instant, näin. Aika uskomatonta.
Okay, so let's see how this works.
Ilmeisesti jotain jännää tapahtuu, koska nyt lähtee valot pois ja selkeä me nähdään jotain. En mä tiedä mitä, mutta kohta me nähdään. Wow.
Now I switched on, and now you can see that the chips are actually lighting up. So you can see that these are like blue LEDs. And yeah, you can look on the thermal camera now.
Oh, it's getting warmer.
And you can see that the main heat source is the chips, but also the wires that are conducting the current are getting quite hot.
Wait, 90 degrees. That's like Finnish sauna. 110. That's kind of hot. I don't want to touch it. En koskista on kyllä.
In my job, I have to make sure that the tremor profile of the module is according to the specification.
Yeah.
And we also have a model that's running on the car's software, which is constantly calculating how hot the chips are.
Yeah.
And can detect when they are overheating, and then can regulate the power from the car to prevent it from overheating and to always be safe.
Yeah.
By driving.
Yeah.
Kiva nähdä, miltä niinku tämmönen, siis miten tää kaikki tapahtuu. Ei mulla mitään hajua. Mä ajan mun auto kotona ja sit yhtäkkiä tämmönen siellä ja sit mun auto, kun mä painan kaasuun, niin kaikki toimii kivasti. Ja kaikki on Annan ansiosta. Tai ei kaikki, mutta aika paljon. Thank you, Anna. This was amazing. Thanks for telling me about this whole thing. Wow, it's
amazing.
Thank
you for coming and for your interesting questions.
Thank you very much. Kiitos kun katoitte. Toivottavasti tykkäsitte yhtä paljon niin kuin meitsi ja toivottavasti te opitte myös samalla jotain uutta. Ensi kerralla, kun sä istasat autoon tai selotat puhelinta, mieti hetki, minkälaista teknologiaa Boschilta sulla saattaa olla siinä laitteessa. Jos sä tykkäsit tästä videosta, niin käy tsiigaamassa 2 muuta videota. Ne löytyy Boschin YouTubesta tai Boschin sivustolta. Ei muuta kuin nähdään ensi videon parissa. Moi!